a doctor as long as I got to bring a smile on people's faces and see them walk out healed and, you know, do the most. Do the most. Welcome again, guys, to my YouTube channel. Thank you guys for always viewing. Thank you for always liking. Thank you for always subscribing. You guys are the best. I appreciate each and every one of you. Okay, so today I'm gonna rush through this. Hey, I want to talk about my career, or how I got to where I am. So this is what happened. This is what inspired. When I was young, I had so many dreams. I was filled with so many dreams. I was like, I want to be a chef. I want to be a baker. I want to do this. I want to do that. You know, I want to cook. I still have the passion for cooking, guys. Yeah, I still do. I still have the passion for cooking. I still have the passion for baking. And my mom bakes when I was young. I used to like be there, you know, get my hands inside. So now this is what happens, and this is what unfolds in life. What happened is that I went to varsity, right? I went to the Northwest University of Potchefstroom. I studied my nursing there. I used to go to university. No, I've never failed in life. I went from grade 1 to grade 12. No fail, nothing, zilch, everything was good. And then you're like, in 4 years, I'll be done with my degree. Yes, I'll be done. But you know what happens? What happens is that life doesn't, you know, things go the way they want to go. You can plan to go straight. The next thing, life is like, shut Kev. So, yeah. I studied nursing, honors in nursing sciences. I'm sorry, guys, I just never say it that much. So I did my first year, everything was good, but the challenges were humongous. When I started, with our first class, when we started, they told us this: the following day you must be in your uniforms, we're going to the hospital. You know what happened to me that day? I actually freaked out because I did not sign up for this. I didn't know this is what happens when you do nursing. I thought you just study and then you go to the hospital, to the clinic, and you do whatever you have to do, heal the people, you know. And there are things called practicals, guys. Oh, my heart. I was just traumatized being in a hospital setting for the first time. Since, well, when I was young, my experience with the hospital wasn't so good. So I was like, I'm not ready for this. I am not ready to mingle with patients. I'm not ready to deal with patients. You know, when you are in a hospital setting, you cannot just come in and then do what you do with the patient and you leave. How are they supposed to feel? You're supposed to talk to them. But not, I was not a people's person. I was not. So I just did what I did, left. That was me. I didn't think I was gonna cope with being in the reality setting, like after my degree and working. Second year went well, but then I was hit by depression. I was going through the most in life. So I happened to fail like one module. So that one module was a year module, and then it actually took me to study for 5 years. I was devastated because I had plans, guys. I had plans. I was like, oh, at 21 I'll be done, I'll be working. Life was like, no honey, it's not working. So I had to accept what had happened. It took me time though. And then I went to third year, fourth year, fifth year. Things were not so smooth sailing because I had friends and they were moving way forward than I am. And your life was just too much. And then my final year, I was like, you know what? I'm running for this. I'm going to do my best. I'm going to run. I'm going to, you know, do the most. And then when I was studying for my final exams, I told myself that, you know, to get the marks that I want, I have to aim higher. So that when I fall, I don't fall way, way below. I did that. I passed. I was happy. When they were saying to us that graduation ceremony, what? I was so excited. I was so excited. But here's the reality of working in a clinic setting or a hospital setting. You expect things to go so smoothly. You expect patients to be so happy when they see you. You expect patients to be so grateful to have a person like you helping them and whatnot. That's not the reality. The reality is that when patients see you, all they see is stress. You are stressing them out. You are not giving them the medication that they want. You are not giving them the help that they want. You are just setting them back. When you tell them, we do not have that medication, like for now, we don't have free medication in the facilities. You can only get it at the pharmacy. So when you tell them that, it's like you are taking a knife and sticking it in their back. That's just how it feels when the patient sees us. When you tell them, I have to send you to the hospital, it's like you are sending them to their death sentence. It's hard. It's hard being a nurse. You have to advocate for them. Sometimes they don't want you to even advocate for them because they can make decisions for themselves. Sometimes you try your level best. The system fails you. The patient doesn't see that. All they see is an incompetent nurse. And that's not who we are. We are strong. We are fighting in the background. If you go to a setting, a clinic setting, and you meet those rude nurses, those you're like, hey, Dolamo, hey, SSO, hey, Volamo, Otenelang, you know. I don't blame them. I don't blame them, guys. I don't blame them at all. We are exhausted. We are so flippin' exhausted to a point that sometimes when you come and you yell at us, we yell back because you are not listening. I feel like I'm talking to like, okay, fine. You know what happens? What happens is that sometimes when you get into a consultation room, I once spoke to this other patient, man. She was very furious. She was very angry that I'm not helping her. And then I told her, you know what? I feel like the minute you left at home, you were already stressed. That's why when you get here, you are taking all your stress. You're giving it back to me. Now I'm supposed to calm down because she's there. And I'm supposed to be here now. So it was not an easy process. It was not an easy task. So yeah. Life is not easy. Life of being a nurse is not easy. We try our level best to come through for the patients. We try our level best. If there's no medication, patients blame us. If there's no food at the hospitals, patients blame us. If they don't get what they want, they blame us. Everything, because we are the face of health. So everything is getting, it's being blamed on us, even though it's not our fault. So I never thought nursing would be like this, honestly. I always heard people complain about nurses and whatnot. But now that I'm in the field, I understand why nurses are the way they are. I'm not saying it's right, but I understand. So I actually wanted to be a doctor. But now that I'm a nurse, I'm getting to see that, you know, nurses do so much more. They do a whole lot. They do so much. They do more than you can ever imagine. So people tend to trust, like if you come into the consultation room and then you tell me I have this and then I give it to you, they become so happy. So if you don't give it to them, you're the bad nurse. But that's, we're not really bad nurses. We are really trying our level best to come through for our patients. Although some patients don't see that. Even when you try to explain, it's like you're making excuses. So being a nurse is not so easy, but I do not regret the path that I chose. I do not regret it at all. And I'm really proud and happy to be a nurse and to bring a difference in other people's lives, even though some they don't even say it, they don't tell it to your face, but it's actually good to get that feedback from that one patient that would say to you that, you know, this other day when I came, you actually helped me and I'm so grateful. Those are the things that really keep us going. Those are the things that keep us pushing. And when you see them smile and so grateful and actually conversating with you, opening up to you, those are the beautiful things in life, because you feel like actually you are doing something. So that's just how being a nurse is. It's not so easy. You may see us fighting and running and whatnot, but honestly, it isn't easy at all. You may see us going on strikes and whatnot. It's not easy, because we know when you go on strikes, why are we going there? We have reasons. So yeah, that's just a brief up of how it feels like to be a nurse and what a nurse is. And who a nurse is, what the challenges we go through, you know? So yeah, that's just about it, guys. Thank you for watching.